Let us see decision making in Python programming. First one is if statements. So in any program, based on the condition or decision, we should have to execute the group of code. So for this, first we will be looking into if statement. So let us consider example, a is equal to 10. Now based on the condition, whether the if is 10 or not, we will be executing the code. A is equal to 10. Always, whenever you are comparing, you should have to use 2 is equal to signs. And end it, end the statement with a colon. Don't forget to add a colon. And now, print A. We can write any number of code below this if statement. So, these spaces you should have to be careful. If the system doesn't allow it automatically, you should have to intend the space so that anything under this comes will be belonging to this if statement. So now let us write inside this anything you can write this is true. Like this, we can add n number of lines. All the group of code belongs to this condition. If this condition is true, this will be executed. Otherwise, this will be ignored. Now let us press enter one more time. So, because in this case, a is equal to 10, this both the statements got executed. Let us see what happens if you a is equal to, let us say 20. So now, we forgot to add a colon, never forgot to add a colon, a is equal to 20. So this is the benefit of the idle. As soon as we can see the syntax error. But if you write in a file, it will show the error only after writing the entire program. So always test your program first in a Python shell. Now if you write a is equal to 20 and write print a, and print this is true, the same one. And now if you once again press the enter, so nothing, there is no output because this condition is false. We can also use the nested statements, like let us say a is equal to 10 and b is equal to 20. Now if you want to write the nested if conditions, like if a is equal to 20, first it will print the value of a, and then we can write another statements like this is false, let us make it 10 true first to understand it better. And now we can write another if statement inside it. This is a nested if statements, and b is equal to 20. Oh, again we forgot the colon. If a is equal to 10, give the colon, print a. If b is equal to 20, give the colon, and in under it print the value of b. Now let us execute it, press enter and press one more time enter. See here, both the numbers are printed. Why? Because first this condition is true, the execution come to this line, it will print the value of a. And again, it will come to this line and check this condition. So in this case, this condition is also true. That's why it is printing this also. Let us make one of them false. If we make the first one false, the whole, this entire code will be skipped because all this code comes under the if. So first one, if we make first one false, it will directly jump to the out of the this group of code. So let us give a is equal to 10, the same, don't forget the colon, like print a. And now if b is equal to 23. This is false. Now let us see what happened. Print the value of b and again press enter. See, now this line is getting executed again. Here this condition is false, so it is skipping the code under this if statement. So hope you understood. This is all about decision making using the if statement.